I believe your quote, exact quote is, difficult to maintain fiscal discipline.
Sorry, let me hear that.
It will be difficult to maintain fiscal discipline.
Sorry, just one moment. Sorry.
Okay, we will get the exact quote, but let me put it in my words. You will not, ma'am, you will have a slippage in your fiscal deficit
this
year.
That's all right.
That's my argument.
Put it into my mouth.
And I think you will have to readjust your figure as your predecessors have had to do. And that's unfortunately the reality we're facing today. Now, on the economic conditions under which the supplementary demands are coming in, we all know that traditional economic wisdom dictates that the GDP of the country will only grow if the key contributors to it expand, such as investment, manufacturing, consumption, exports. But here we have a peculiar situation where all of these are going down and have in fact hit rock bottom. But the government still believes it can sell the idea of a $5 trillion economy without offering us a roadmap of exactly how this will happen. At least the Prime Minister keeps talking of a $5 trillion GDP, but the Honorable Mr. Nishikant Dubey believes that GDP is not important, and I'm not sure who is the more reputed economist amongst the two of them. But the fact is that GDP growth rate in the most recent quarter has been considerably lower than such fevered fantasies at a tepid 4.5%, a sixth consecutive quarter of slowing growth. The new figures represent a stunning decline. The country's GDP was growing by more than 9% at the start of 2016, a legacy of the Manmohan Singh years. And today, 4.5% has become the new normal. So with GDP growth at a 16-year low, unemployment at a 46-year high, household consumption at a four-decade low, bad loans and a rising number of non-performing assets, we are also witnessing an all-time high in terms of a drop in private investment. If we look at unemployment today, it's 7.48% in November. The labor participation rate is the lowest it's been in recent memory. And in fact, the unemployment rate touched a three-year high in October of 8.45%. In rural areas, it's doubled from 2013-14 fiscal year to 17-18 fiscal year. There's been over a 50% increase in employment in many sectors in the urban areas, and urban males in particular have suffered. As per a working paper published by the Azim Premji University, we've seen a 9 million people losing jobs between 2012 and 2018, and that's an average of about a couple of million a year between these crucial periods that the BJP was largely in power. This clearly called for remedial measures under the supplementary demands for grants to do something about employment generation, but these are not forthcoming. Instead, what do we have? We have salaries for police and armed forces, under which the government proposes to spend 3,387 crores to pay salaries and the cost of rations for the police, 2,000 crores for payment of salaries and allowances for the armed corps forces. But supplementary demands for grants are meant for expenditures that could not have been anticipated in the regular budget. But these are standard exercises, these salaries and ration costs. They haven't gone up since the budget was approved. Why was this not anticipated instead of coming back to us 4 months after the budget was already approved? Now, if you look at the situation that we are seeing in the country, sir, the National Statistical Office tells us that rural poverty has risen nearly 4 percentage points to 30%, and that given the size of the rural population, the overall estimated poverty rate has gone up nearly a percentage point to 23%, which means, simple mathematics, that about 30 million people have fallen behind or below our India's official poverty line in the last 6 years that the BJP has been in power.
Kyunki 2008 se lekar 2014 tak inke sab phone pe chala, inko deo, inko do, loan dete jao. चाचा भतीजा भाई बहन सबको मिला हैं जी एज अ रिजल्ट हां सो ड्यू टू द एग्रेसिव लेंडिंग फ्रॉम 2008 टू 2014 ग्रोस एडवांसेस ऑफ आईडीबीआई बैंक इंक्रीज्ड फ्रॉम 82,664 crores to 2,03,376 crores. Rampant, mela. Sabko de do, ye hua. All right? Stress loans, dusra dekh lijiye. Abhi kya ho rahi hai? Ek mahine ke baad interest nahi diye to kanun and meaning prudential norms ke tahat interest nahi diye to stress loan. Phir stress one, stress two, phir NPA ho jata hai na. Hum sabko malum hai. Stress loans were not even recognized as NPA. Chhod diya. Are, hamara hai ji, chhodo. Khayega paisa.
Phone loan.
Chhod diya. IDBI's loans were all left without being categorized as NPA. Stressed accounts continued. The loans kept going. Under asset quality review, stress loans were recognized as NPA transparently since after 2015. Usse pehle nahi hua. And losses were provided for. Abhi bhi sab log puchte hain. Losses de rahe ho, matlab write-off kar rahe ho. Write-off nahi karte, magar isaf kitab maintain karne ke samay, any chartered accountant will know, you have to provide for the books to be balanced. Magar uska matlab ye nahi hai ki unko chhod dete hain. Unko piche padte hain, unke sampatti ko jabt karte hain. And usko auction karke us paiso ko vaapas le aayenge. Magar wo sab karyakram shuru hua 2015 se, usse pehle nahi. IDBI ka halat ke upar itne sare log kya bolte hain, crocodile tears shed kar rahe ho? Kaise shed kar rahe ho ji? Suno wo, aur suno. As a result, gross NPAs of the bank rose from 12,685 crores. NPA उधर से मार्च 2015 को इतना हमने recognize किया 12,685 crores recognize किया 2015 में. वो बढ़ते बढ़ते कहां तक पहुंचा? 60,875 crores by September of 2018, IDBI की हालत. अब बार बार, नहीं नहीं, एक मिनट. Oh, professor, you can't. You will have to get an answer on that also. No. ये professor जी के question ये है कि 2018 मतलब आपकी time है. Loan तब का mature होते होते NPA बना हमारे time में. मगर लोन देन आपका है जी, आपके समय का लोन है, वो बाद में आकर के एनपीए हुआ. ओके, फिर ठीक है. वो चार फोर आर वन यू कैन आस्क ऑल दैट यू प्लीज सर. यस सुप्रिया जी,
सर टेक क्वालिटी यू
परमिशन सिंस आई हैड. I appreciate everything that you're saying, but a lot has been said about the mudra loans. So my question to you, very humbly put, is that according to the data that is accessible to us, for about 53%, mudra was started by you, 53% of the loans are NPA, which is 4 lakh crores. This is what, Dhawan? महिला सक्षम है, महिला सक्षम है, उसको अपना मत बना, सबला है ये महिला. She doesn't need to be defended. And one more small question, since you talked about onions, I just have a small query that I appreciate that you managed getting onions from Egypt. I come from Maharashtra, which is the largest pool collector of onions. Why has the production gone down? A. B. Bharti Pawar, she's sitting right here, she represents Nasik, so she will agree with me. This is not a political point I'm making at all. But the onion prices, when they were rock bottom, is the time of duration you gave. Was that the reason that they did not get the rice, remitter of prices, the MSP was not good, hence was the production gone down? Because I take great pride in being an Indian and proud to be an Indian, which feeds every Indian's mouth. So why has the production gone down? I'm not happy eating Egyptian onions. Why should India do it? And we export rice, we export milk, so many products. We are the second largest rice producer in the world, and wheat. Why are we doing this? Isn't it a regressive step? If you could kindly clarify both the points about the mudra loan, which is NPA, as well as the onions, because the onion grower is the small farmer. the onion farmer is not the 20 and 30 acre one. He's the small farmer with less water. So he really needs to be protected, is my request.
In fact, मैं इतना लहसुन प्याज नहीं खाती हूँ जी, so don't worry. मैं ऐसे परिवार से आती हूँ जहाँ अनियन प्याज का मतलब नहीं रखते हैं.
तो जब ऑनियन की शॉर्टफॉल हो रहे थे तो पीएमटी मेजर के तहत तुरंत बाहर से क्यों नहीं आयात किया आपने? अगर ठीक तरीके से आयात करते थे तो इस हालत नहीं होते. और दूसरी बात, आप कुछ कहते हैं कि बिचौलिया आ गए, जमाखोर आ गए, तो वजह क्या है? तो बिचौलिया के चलते, जमाखोर के चलते, ये आपकी सरकार की जो रवैया उसकी कमियां की चलते, सरकार की कामकाज की कोई कमियां की चलते, बिचौलिया की चलते, जमाखोरी की चलते, या सही वक्त पर आयात नहीं किया गया इसी के चलते, वजह क्या आप जानना चाहते हैं?
सर, ओनली इज नॉट द ओनली,
नो नो, आई एम एड्रेसिंग ऑन एवरीथिंग ऑल्सो. प्रेमचंद्रन जी, प्रेमचंद्रन जी, प्रेमचंद्रन जी, आई एम एड्रेसिंग एवरी इश्यू. I am also addressing the issue raised by one of the honorable members, and therefore you should have the patience to listen to that also. No, I will listen to you. All right. Onion is something which even Adhir ji raised, Maharashtra MPs raised. So it's my duty to respond to them also. Hold on, hold on.